Welcome to an example on how to graph a parabola and find the key components of the parabola. The first thing we should notice is, looking at the form of the equation, the x part is being squared, and therefore the parabola will have a vertical axis or vertical axis of symmetry, which means the parabola will either open up or open down. So now for the next step, let's determine the value of a to determine if the parabola opens up or if it opens down. Remember, if a is negative, the parabola opens down. If a is positive, the parabola opens up. So 4a must equal negative 6. So if we divide both sides by 4, we can see that a is going to be equal to negative 6 fourths or negative 3 halves, which is also equal to negative 1.5. So because the value of a is negative, we know our parabola will open down. Now I do want to mention that even though our notes below here involve a parabola that opens up, all the formulas for the axis, focus, vertex, and directrix will still work, but I think it's more helpful if we determine these key components by analyzing the graph. So let's first find the vertex. We know the vertex has coordinates h, k. So because we have the quantity x plus 1, the x coordinate is negative 1. And because we have the quantity y minus 4, the y coordinate is positive 4. So let's start by plotting the vertex on the coordinate plane. Negative 1, 4 would be here. We'll go ahead and label this v for vertex. And then because we know the parabola opens down, we're going to make a rough sketch of the parabola, and then later we'll make a more accurate sketch. So we know it's going to look something like this. The reason this is helpful is we should now recognize that the focus will be below the vertex, or inside the parabola, and the directrix will be a horizontal line that's going to be above the vertex. And the distance from the vertex to the focus is equal to the absolute value of a, and the distance from the vertex to the directrix is also equal to the absolute value of a. So in this case, notice that a is equal to negative 3 halves, and the absolute value of negative 3 halves is positive 3 halves, which means the focus would be 3 halves units below the vertex, or this point here. We could also say 1.5 units below. And we know the directrix would be a horizontal line, 3 halves units or 1.5 units above the vertex. So the directrix would pass through this point, and again it would be a horizontal line. So knowing the distance from the vertex to the focus is 3 halves units, and the distance from the vertex to the directrix is 3 halves units, we can now determine the coordinates of the focus and the equation of the directrix. Notice how the focus would have the same x-coordinate of the vertex, negative 1, but we'd have to subtract 3 halves from the y-coordinate because it's 3 halves below the vertex. 4 minus 3 halves is the same as 8 halves minus 3 halves, which would be 5 halves. Now if we go strictly by the formula, it tells us the y-coordinate would be k plus a, which would be 4 plus negative 3 halves, which of course is the same as just minus 3 halves, which we did. And then for the directrix, because it's 3 halves units above the vertex, if we add 3 halves to the y-coordinate of the vertex, this will give us the equation for the directrix. 4 plus 3 halves, which is the same as 8 halves plus 3 halves, would be 11 halves, so the equation is y equals 11 halves. Or we can just tell from the graph, this would be y equals 5.5, which is equal to 11 halves. So the nice thing about graphing it as we go is that we can also verify our work actually finding the points or the equations on the coordinate plane. And now for the equation of the axis, we know it's going to be a vertical line, cuts the parabola in half or passes through the vertex and the focus, this vertical line here, which again we can see would be x equals negative 1. It's also equal to x equals h, or the x-coordinate of the vertex. Notice how our parabola is also symmetrical across the axis. And then finally, we're going to find the endpoints of the latus rectum, or focal diameter, which will also allow us to sketch a more accurate parabola. Latus rectum is this green segment here that's parallel to the directrix, passes through the focus with endpoints on the parabola. The length of the latus rectum is equal to the absolute value of 4a, or in this case, the absolute value of negative 6, which is equal to positive 6. So if we cut that in half, that means to find the endpoints of the latus rectum, we'll go 3 units to the right of the focus, which would be here, and 3 units to the left of the focus here. These would be the two endpoints of our latus rectum, or focal diameter. So to find these coordinates, we'll have to add and subtract 3 from the x-coordinate of the focus. Or of course, we can just look on the coordinate plane. Notice how this point has coordinates 2, 5 halves. And the coordinate on the left here would be negative 4, 5 halves. Also notice that if we look at the x-coordinate of the focus, if we add 3, negative 1 plus 3 is equal to positive 2, the x-coordinate of the first endpoint. And then if we subtract 3, negative 1 minus 3 is negative 4, giving us the x-coordinate of the other endpoint. And we also know these two endpoints would be on the parabola. So now we'll make a more accurate sketch. The parabola must pass through the vertex and these two endpoints, so it would look something like this. If we wanted a more accurate sketch, we could find the intercepts or make a table of values. I hope this was helpful.